All right, so this is part three of the EF build, and I didn't show it on camera, but we got some new parts. We got the OBD0 to OBD1 conversion harness from Y-Wire for the distributor. We also got it for the alternator, but we're not quite ready to put that in yet. Also got this in the mail today, conversion OBD0 to OBD1 ECU for the P28. So hopefully once we put this in, we put some kind of power source on it, the car will shoot fuel, because I still don't know if the pump's any good. And if I do get fuel that comes out, or I hear the pump prime, maybe it won't have gas, so I'll have to put gas. I also want to get fluids for the engine and the transmission. Hopefully get it cranking by the end of this video. So let's see how much we get.
Really simple, just plugged in the body harness into the adapter and this to the ECU. There's this pin, I believe it'll be for the O2 sensor, idle air control valve maybe, VTEC, something else. I'm not gonna do this quite yet. Like I always say, I kept saying, priority is just to get this thing started. But that's just one big piece of the puzzle. So right now I'm gonna put some power on and we'll see if we get the pump to turn on.
All right, power is on. I'm going to turn the key, see if we get anything. Nothing's happening. Not good. So it's the next day. I ended up working on this car till like midnight, trying to figure out why the fuel pump wouldn't power on. I followed the wire through here. It doesn't go directly to the main relay. It comes up over here where there's a very beautiful melted wire. And this is our fuel pump wire right here. And that goes on the fuse box, then connects to this, I believe. And this goes somewhere into no man's land behind the dash. So I don't even know where to start with that. Our relay does send power to the black and yellow, but somewhere from here to the pump, I get nothing. So this is gonna be a fun little project. It'd be much easier if it would show me where this goes. I'm kind of just guessing, and it goes up in a dash, and then I lose it because I can't see. So that's today's project. Well, I did confirm the fuel pump worked though. I put power directly to it. The gas in it smells absolutely terrible. Voltmeter from $8 voltmeters putting in work. I should probably get a better one, but it's doing the job for now. So I'll update you guys when I actually figure out what's going on with this wiring. And if anything, I'm pretty sure I could just take this wire and run it straight to the black and yellow on the pump. So I forgot to record it, but that one wire that's by itself, for whatever reason, the fuel pump wire that's supposed to get power is that one. Took a break from the wiring, went to Walmart, got the best they had to offer, SuperTech. So I found out, or I Googled it, it says 10W30 is pretty much the same as Honda manual transmission fluid. I'm sure it'll work. So I got only 2 quarts, it takes like 2.1 something, but for the sake of starting it up, 2 will be fine. Engine oil also went with the SuperTech. So we got 4 quarts of that. We got some 2.5 gallons of gasoline. Put that in, then I think I'm just gonna take this wire I talked about here, the red green chaser, and then just kind of splice it into this right here, and then see if the pump will prime at that point. And then hook up the starter wire once we get the fluids in and attempt to crank it. I don't expect it to start. Actually, I'm not even up to that part. I still got to add this fitting, which I do have, and then we can try to start it. And like I was about to say, I don't expect it to start. If it does, that'd be insane. So let me, start filling it up, I guess. Tip, when filling the transmission, I always put it through where the speed sensor goes. I did it on my K series, works the same on B series. Sure works the same with D-series. So instead of making a mess with the side plug, just remove your speed sensor. As simple as that.
So it is hot as hell.
You probably can't tell on camera, but it feels super hot. But I managed to fill the oil, fill the transmission. I ran some random vacuum lines so there wouldn't be leaks. I put a random wire on the starter. Everything's gonna be jumped. Everything's gonna be powered by a jump box. So, not gonna put a battery in it quite yet. I think without doing that fuel thing, I just wanna see if it's gonna crank over. So I'm gonna hook up the jumper and see if we get some crank. Jumper on, come inside here. And nothing. I could have guessed. Well, I just did it, but to verify that the starter does work, I put power from here to the solenoid. And it cranked. We need to get that to work, and we need the rest of it to work. We might be getting somewhere. Right, so if you watched my Instagram video, you would see that I got it started. And let me explain exactly how I did it. Because we didn't get the key on. You saw that part. But I spent like another 2 days just diagnosing a no spark issue, which turned out to be the igniter wire that's on this side that I had to go all the way over here. Yes, it's just a wire, but it was just for testing purposes. So basically, what my guess is that this car has an HF CRX harness, because I believe the SI igniter wire is still on this side and the HF CRX is on that side. So I was just checking continuity, doing blah blah blah, and I found out that this was pinned to a 5-volt reference, which is this yellow white wire, and that checked continuity and it went to the ECU pins for the igniter. Turn key on, give the ECU power, tested power there. I do have power, so I just ran the wire here to the igniter and still couldn't get it started with the key. So I jumped the starter, sprayed some carb cleaner, and it started for about 5 seconds. So it did run, and what I'm doing now is trying to use this battery cable that was on my EG. I think it was either the EG or the EM1 build, I don't know. But I want to run this so I don't have to use the jump pack wherever it is. I could use this battery that also came off the EG. It has like 9 volts, but we could juice it up and then kind of clean up things and set grounds instead of using the jump pack to ground everything and to power everything, because it's really bugging me how many wires are everywhere. So that's what I'm going to do right now. Set this up. I do have a battery tray, but I don't plan on putting it in right now just because of basically still testing things. So once I have that set up, I'll show you. All right, so this is our temporary setup. We got this to the fuse box, goes on this to the starter. We've got the negative to the chassis. And then from there, it's one wire, I don't know why, to the transmission, from valve cover to radiator support. Check continuity. We have good grounds across the board. I think at this point I'm gonna hook up the positive. It's gonna need a jumper, but I don't know. The battery's not totally dead, but it's got some power, so maybe we can charge that up some other time so we can use it more. Grounds, I just tested it. Well, I'm about to show you. Grounds are good. I just tied clutch solenoid wires together somewhere over there. Check this out. Cranking all on its own. Fuel pump isn't priming. So, I don't know if I showed you this. This wire here is our power wire. Whatever reason why this is their power to the pump, we need to figure that out. But I think we can get it started if we just put power on this. So that's what I'm about to do. All right, so let me tell you exactly what I just did, and everything worked. Everything is temporary, so it looks sketchy, just like how the other idiot had it. So we have our power wire that for some reason goes to this, directly to the relay. I couldn't find out, I think they put in a kill switch for the grounds, which are here.
So I don't know if they put a kill switch in secretly. I don't know. Then, since this thing is running on OBD1 injectors, we take the resistor box wires, we tie them all together. I just cranked it and it just started. I'm gonna do it again. This should be, hopefully, just start relatively fast. It's running. She's running. I died as soon as I give a guess. Maybe that's the fact that we don't have a map sensor connected, or that we have a vacuum leak. I'm guessing this is like a vacuum leak. I don't know. But that is awesome that it just cranked and it just started.
Map sensor is wired up.
It should rev. Oh, we got gas coming out. There's a big leak.
I am happy at where I am with the car at this point. Before I need to start cleaning up everything, I need to figure out where the hell the battery goes. I'm guessing it goes vertical, but there's probably a plastic tray that needs to be there, and there isn't. What else? Oh, the gas that was leaking. I just put this return hose on without a clamp, but I think what I should do is just take off the hose and let all the crappy fuel out, because the fuel was brown. I wish you could smell it. It smells terrible. My wife's probably going to kill me because of how stinky it is. It's like ridiculous. The fuel pump is grounded to the chassis. Obviously, that needs to be cleaned up. The fuel pump power wire is tied into where it's supposed to be. I kind of just jumped it. That needs to be cleaned up. Obviously, all this needs to be put back in place, but I took it all down to just review over everything. We still need to put an axle in. We could attempt to drive it at some point soon, but I kind of want to clean everything up. Also, these seats are from like a 90-91, so the brackets are different, so if I do drive it, I might just fall out and bust myself. So, I mean, super awesome, great progress, and this is only the third video, so I hope and pray it only gets better from here, because I really got a lot done in what, a week and a half time, I believe it's been. So, super happy.
All right, so, like I keep saying, I'm super happy with it. It's not my car, must I remind you, but I'm still happy that we got that progress done with the EF, and everything was messed up with this car. The engine wire, the engine harness was different. The interior harness is different. Everything was screwed up, everything was touched, and I managed to get it to run. And it revs, and it sounds damn good. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know I did. I'm really hyped for what's to come. Still lots to do, a lot of tidying up, but at least we're getting there. So, hope you guys enjoyed it. Any questions about this build, my past builds with my K-Series, even the SAR, which is waiting on a BorgWarner Turbo that's back-ordered forever. Hit me up on Instagram, JZChris92. Till next time, later.